Common causes of small fiber neuropathy. It's not always diabetes. There's a lot of other reasons that a patient could have this type of neuropathy. So, of course, we have diabetes mellitus, both type 1 and type 2. It can be idiopathic. Metabolic syndromes, such as patients who are pre-diabetic with altered glucose, which is a very heavy population here in the U.S. I think it's about 67% of the population is pre-diabetic. So anybody could have neuropathy type symptoms. Alcohol abuse, history of HIV, amyloidosis, any kind of pharmacological toxin, solvent exposures, post-chemo patients, leprosy, vasculitis, and various autoimmune disorders. I've been seeing a lot of chemotherapy-induced neuropathy in my practice. There's a big oncology center across the street, and it is amazing how much of these chemo patients start to experience these. Not only are they losing their toenails and fingernails, but also they're getting pretty severe neuropathy-type symptoms. And I have patients that are 20 years post-chemo, and they're still having these symptoms that have never been addressed. And these are patients that doing a test like ENFT can really help them so that the nerves are not progressively worsening and their neuropathy is not progressively worsening, because this is a temporary thing for them. And if we address them in a timely manner, we are able to really reverse their symptoms and make it much more tolerable for them, rather than letting it go for 20 years and those nerves just progressively worsening over time. So you're doing these patients a huge favor, and they will appreciate you so much for diagnosing them early and giving them a way to do their daily walks and live their daily life without that burning pain, that paresthesia type pain, the numbness in their feet.